Coming up on this week's news, the authors of the wiring regulations weigh in on the cable overloading debate, how a misconnected CT clamp led to a homeowner being charged £5 just to boil a kettle, and an electrical crime arrives on the doorstep of eFIXX headquarters. Welcome to Electrical News Weekly in association with Solar Trade Sales, your easy one-stop shop for all things solar. Whether you're listening in the van, on site, or down at the wholesale counter, I'm Joe Robinson, and I've been through the best of the electrical industry news to save you the trouble. And if you think you've spotted the two words that I've been challenged to slip into this week's show, comment with them below for the chance to win a prize. The authors of the wiring regulations have weighed in on a long-time debate over cable overloading. The IET says they want to bust some myths on the topic that many electricians hold dear. They cite the example of a 1 square millimetre twin and earth cable, which typically has a current rating of around 14 amps, connected to a 32 amp circuit breaker. Another is a 10 amp kettle lead plugged into a 13 amp socket. Many in the trade would label both of these as bad practice. But the IET's experts say that to get the answer, we need to refer back to regulation 131.4 on overload protection. The clue, they say, is in the title. Not everything is likely to overload. Examples include filament lamps, heating elements, and power supplies with internal protection. The IET ruling says that if the equipment can't overload the cable supplying it, then it doesn't require overload protection. On this basis, a 1 square millimetre cable connected to a 32 amp circuit breaker powering a dedicated load of 20 watts Wi-Fi access point could be acceptable in a controlled environment. In fact, the concept is specifically spelled out in an often overlooked regulation, 433.3.1. It says that a device for protection against overload need not be provided if the conductor is powering a load that's unlikely to carry overload current. That's provided, of course, that the conductor is protected against fault current in accordance with the requirements of section 434. So that's that debate cleared up. Or is it? Pop your view in the comments. And for much more information on this subject and this regulation, click the link in the show notes to our free training package from Marshall Tufflex on underfloor wiring systems. In other news, it's been revealed that a misconnected CT clamp resulted in homeowners being charged £5 just to boil a kettle. Ford and Ann Jones went into a panic when their newly installed smart meter showed it adding a fiver to their electricity bill. They then tried the washing machine and found that they were charged £15 to clean their clothes. In the first 3 months with the new meter, the couple were charged £3,000. That's more than 10 times their usual bill. Octopus Energy, their supplier, couldn't get to the bottom of the problem. It was only as their heads were about to prematurely exfoliate when they got in touch with an independent engineer who had fixed solar panels to their roof that he spotted a CT clamp had been reconnected the wrong way round. It was this that was causing the meter readings to go haywire. A CT clamp, the CT stands for current transformer, measures power use in amps. It's crucial that's pointing in the right direction. Experts believe this is far from an isolated incident. Electrician Dave Cookman told the This Is Money website that he was called out a dozen times last year to reversed CT terminals. He says the problem often arises when smart meters are fitted to a home with solar panels. If the meter is installed by someone not skilled at handling the technology and they put the magnetic clamp in the wrong direction, the reader won't have a clue what's going on. Cookman believes energy suppliers such as Octopus are keen not to admit responsibility. For its part, Octopus Energy says that it fits thousands of clamps a year and reversing one is a very rare error. Still on solar, it's been revealed that putting in PV panels is comparable to a full body workout at the gym. GB Energy tracked one of its installers for a week and the results show the extraordinary physicality of the job. Its monitored individual walked an average of 10.5 kilometres a day for 5 days. That's about 14,000 steps daily. He also climbed 34 flights of stairs and in total burned an average of 2,215 calories each day. Luke Antonio of GB Energy says the results show how much energy a member of its hardworking team uses up, all in the name of sustainable energy. And now, with the lighter electrical news, it's time for Tea Break with Safe Connect and their range of indicators for overheating electrical connections. Ever heard the phrase, having an ace up your sleeve? Well, how about an electrician in your side? That's exactly what saved Sittingbourne in their FA Trophy clash with Salisbury after a mid-match floodlight failure at the Raymond McNeil Stadium. At half-time, with the score tied at 0-0, it looked like the match might be abandoned when the lights went out. Enter Sittingbourne's unsung hero, a player who also happens to be a Sparky. While Salisbury fans held their breath, the Brickies' multitasking maestro saved the day, getting the lights back on. But here's the kicker. Once play resumed, Salisbury might have wished the lights had stayed off. Sittingbourne struck twice, taking the match 2-1 and booking a date with Southend United. Who is this mystery electrician? No idea. But Salisbury's fans probably won't be booking him for any home repairs anytime soon. That was the lighter electrical news in Tea Break with Safe Connect. Click the link to check out their range of indicators for overheating electrical connections. In product news, a simple new device has been developed to speed up the installation of lighting pendants, pull cords and smoke alarms. In fact, it helps attach anything to plasterboard that requires one or two screws. ChumpFix is a perforated piece of plastic about the size of a small ruler. You push it up through a 25mm hole, usually the same one for the cable, and then flatten it by pulling the handle. You then screw through the plaster to reach one of its many holes. It means you don't have to use wall plugs, and it helps to spread the weight of the light across the ceiling. It also minimises the risk of plasterboard failure caused by drilling near the edges, and we've all been there. This innovation isn't yet in wholesalers, so I've popped the link for online sales into the show notes. Brady's Express Labels mobile app introduces a voice control feature designed to streamline electricians' workflows. This innovation allows users to create and print labels using simple voice commands, reducing manual input and enhancing efficiency. By integrating voice control, electricians can maintain focus on their tasks without the need to handle devices directly, promoting safety and productivity. The app supports a wide range of label types, ensuring versatility for various electrical applications. Available for both iOS and Android devices, Express Labels Mobile is set to become an essential tool for modern electricians seeking to optimise their labelling processes. Schneider Electric has unveiled a buzzbar trunking product specially to supply electric vehicle charging stations. The Canalis for EV system allows for configurations up to 400 amps and is suitable for outdoor use. It's a modular plug-and-play platform that reduces the amount of civils work that needs to be done. Tap-off points along the buzzbar connect to individual chargers. There's even an option to provide lighting, as often charging stations can be dark and unwelcoming. Still on innovation in EV charging, an American firm has developed a flat charging cable to eliminate trips and slips. The Ghost cable is just 6mm thick and 8cm wide. It comes in lengths of up to 24 feet and in voltages of 110 and 220 volts. The firm says that traditional round cables can be tedious, bulky, and hazardous in urban areas. Its cable is engineered to lay flat, reducing tripping risks and rolling up easily for storage. Luceco has launched a new selection of exterior decorative lighting, including solar lights and mains-powered bulkheads. The wired bulkheads come with an eFIXX wall bracket for ease of installation. They have an IP54 plus rating and tough materials to ensure year-round efficiency. There's also multiple modes and colour temperature options. And speaking of lighting, our most recent question of the week came from our free training package on the subject of emergency lighting made with support from Robus. The question was, what is the minimum maintained illuminance level required on the reference plane in high-risk areas for the usual task to take place? And we had a bit of a shocker on this one. The correct answer is just 10% and not less than 15 lux. However, on YouTube, only 21% of respondents got it right, and for the second week running, LinkedIn respondents proved themselves to be slightly better informed, with 27% getting it right. I think either way, though, it's fair to say that taking that free training course from Robus on emergency lighting might be a good idea. The link's in the show notes. And finally, to a new feature, crime news. Actually, rename that Crime on Our Doorstep News. That's because criminality has arrived in sleepy Skipton, the Yorkshire home of the eFIXX HQ and studios. A woman decided to help herself to a distinctive light fitting from the eFIXX team's favourite fish and chip shop. A security camera caught the egregious lady standing on the seats to remove the pendant. The video has now gone viral. It's been seen as far away as Harrogate. Some may view the heist at the fish and chip shop as small fry, but locals are concerned the town's reputation will take a battering. After all, no one steals an LED light just for the halibut. This place is floundering until salmon opens up to the crime. Apologies, I've used my allocation of piscine puns now. Feel free to add your own below, though. We will, of course, keep you posted if the police make a catch. Seems I misled you about my allocation. And finally, our usual reminder that we're in the market for your stories, your projects, and your recommendations, as we'd like to share them with the wider eFIXX community. Send us pictures of your installs or let us know if you've come across any new kit that's making your job easier. And just before we get to your favourite bit of the show, where I reveal last week's challenge words and winners, we want to thank our premium partners. We couldn't make the news without you. First up, they're the people who've created the Swiss Army knife of solar inverters, along with all-weather batteries, very much the Boy Scouts of the solar industry. It's SunSync. And speaking of solar, with manufacturing powered by a 250 gigawatt solar PV array, they're literally the greenest test instrument maker in Europe, both physically and ethically. It's KPS. Are you a bit of a control freak? Motor control, that is. If so, with huge stocks and excellent service, check out Crompton Controls, as they said to me in a recent conversation, if we don't have it, then we can build it. And the best thing to come out of Yorkshire since stainless steel, the home of EV Ultra and other groundbreaking and quality products, is Doncaster Cables. Click the links in the show notes to find out more about these great brands. Big thanks to you all. We really appreciate your ongoing support for the news. If you think you know the words that I've smuggled into this week's show, pop your guess into the comments. We'll take all the correct guesses and select one at random to be the winner of an eFIXX goodie bag prize. Answers submitted after about lunchtime on the Thursday after release will not be entered into the draw. Now let's reveal the winners of last week's challenge word competition. Last week's words were bilingual and gotcha. And would you believe it, he's had a long run of being on the back burner, but he's back with a bang. Our most frequent winner of the challenge word competition, it's Mark Just Mark. So very well done to you for, what is it, like the 37th time now, Mark, I think? Anyway, click the link in the show notes to claim your prize. Thanks for listening to this episode of Electrical News Weekly in association with Solar Trade Sales, your easy one-stop shop for all things solar. Remember to click the link in the show notes to check out their online shop. Make sure you subscribe to receive the next update. Thanks for listening, and until next time, have a great week. Stay safe out there, and remember, there's no such thing as a torque-calibrated arm.